Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. Science headlines today show signs that elements of the Electric Universe paradigm are becoming increasingly mainstream. With leaps in technology and data have come the definitive refutation of the notion of an electrically sterile universe. But the basic premise of a cosmos dominated by the gravitational force remains the backbone of standard cosmology. In this episode, Bishop Nicholas Sykes forecasts the perhaps inevitable paradigm shift towards electric universe concepts.
This series of videos has claimed that the existing paradigm of physical science, accepted and taught in the halls of academia as barely challengeable, has actually become unfit for purpose. If, as we have claimed, the Sun and other stars are actually powered electrically from outside their own cores, rather than being powered by nuclear fusion within their cores, this would be a significant instance of the failure of the existing paradigm. Electric universe proponents will not think it strange when the time comes for the whole line of dominoes representing the presently accepted structure of supposedly hard physics, together with those other sciences dependent upon it, to come crashing down. To be sure, such a state of affairs is not altogether new in the world. In the epilogue to his last book, The Discarded Image, Professor C.S. Lewis writes about the medieval model of science and its succession by the currently accepted model in this way. The old astronomy was not in any exact sense refuted by the telescope. The scarred surface of the moon and the satellites of Jupiter can, if one wants, be fitted into a geocentric scheme. The old scheme had been tinkered a good deal to keep up with observations. How far by endless tinkerings it could have kept up with them until even now, I do not know. But the human mind will not endure such ever-increasing complications if once it has seen that some simpler conception can save the appearances. Neither theological prejudice nor vested interests can permanently keep in favour a model which is seen to be grossly uneconomical. The new astronomy triumphed not because the case for the old became desperate, but because the new was a better tool. Once this was grasped, our ingrained conviction that nature herself is thrifty did the rest. When our model is in its turn abandoned, this conviction will no doubt be at work again. Electric universe researchers contend that the EU paradigm is far more economical than the currently accepted model, which has been endlessly tinkered with to keep up with observations, but would also, in my view, judge that the entire case for the standard model has reached the point of desperation. Let us now return to the issue of relativity. Some justifiable excitement appeared in the media over some experimental results that gave the possibility of showing that neutrinos could travel faster than light. Yet the whole of the theory of relativity is dependent upon light, or rather electromagnetic radiation in which light is a part, being the fastest possible messenger. Moreover, the theory of relativity has by now become a core principle that informs the working of the standard model. If relativity falls, then much of what we thought we learned in the last century about the physics of the universe, we know no longer. Inevitably, the question arises, is relativity, like some banks and some countries, too big to fail? With what shall it be bailed out, so that academics and their supporters can again live with some semblance of normality? Of course, this is not a scientific question at all, but it is a question with which electric universe researchers have become all too familiar for not a few years. Nevertheless, there is an increasing number of independent scientists who have proved to the satisfaction of many that the theory of relativity is groundless, in spite of the awe in which it is generally held. I would now like to supply my 2 cents worth to that voice. The celebrated lecturer Richard Feynman noted, if the sun is exploding right now, it takes 8 minutes before we know about it, and it cannot possibly affect us before then. His reason for that assertion is the doctrine that the fastest message that travels between the sun and the earth does so at 3 × 10⁸, 300 million meters per second, the speed of light through space. At that light speed, the sun, viewed from the earth, appears to be where it actually was some 8 minutes ago, and not where it actually is when it is being viewed. However, if the sun, by its gravitational pull, is causing the earth to maintain an orbit around it, the pull of the sun on the earth has to be from almost exactly where it is, and not from where it was 8 minutes beforehand. If the pull of the sun upon the earth came from an 8 minutes back position behind the sun, the earth would be slung out of orbit in short order. Moreover, for each planet, the gravitational pull upon it of the sun would come from a different point, a different virtual sun, so to speak, and no coherent solar system of planets could be maintained. It follows that there must be a much faster messenger than light, namely gravity, that travels between the sun and its planets at a speed that makes the transmission of light seem like a dawdle. We don't need any experiment with neutrinos, therefore, to tell us that something can travel faster than light. We just have to take into account all the observations from which we infer that the Earth and the other planets have been moving round the sun in stable orbits for an extended period of time. This requires the gravitational message to be sent from the sun and received by the Earth as well as other planets almost instantaneously. Einstein's special theory of relativity should therefore have been repealed long ago. Now, Wal Thornhill has applied this near-instantaneous transmission of force to the level of the fundamental particles of matter, such as the electron, providing the possibility of an electrical explanation of gravitation at the subatomic level. We will consider this exciting scenario in future presentations.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.